her son died, and they say, she went to people crying, and they said, go to Buddha, he's enlightened master, he can do something. So she goes to Buddha, instead of saying that your child cannot come back, he teaches her. This is all I want you to do is just to make heal your son and make him alive. Go to any house and get a fistful of mustard seeds. Oh, that is no problem. But only one condition, from the household where no one has died. Okay. So she thought, I'll get it. And then just she went. Parents died, children died, uncle died, everyone. So by the time she went to so many houses, realization came, death is inevitable. So he wanted to teach, you know, lesson like this. People get caught into like spirituality, you know, like spirit lives, what happens, you know. Then he, like the spiritual master said, bring an earthen pot, you know, and then put some stones in it, and then put some ghee, you know, butter on top of it, okay. So rocks are there, butter is there, and break the pot. What happens? Throw in a lid. Rocks go to the bottom, butter floats on the surface. So, the close connection was just like asmita, ego. The rock and butter got connected like we are together. But when it breaks, rocks are rocks, butter is butter. So consciousness is consciousness, body is body, they separate. Okay. So, they teach the lesson by practical example. I wrote a story in attachment, just talking about example, you know. In one ashram, there were disciples, and one disciple was addicted to some bad habit, you know. And master wanted to tell them, get rid of the habit, and he won't understand. So one morning, everyone is sleeping, and he grabs hold of the pole and said, pole got me, the pole got me, get me out, get me out. All the disciples, hey, the one who was addicted, master, no, pole cannot get you, you are grabbing on the pole, let go of it. And he says, well, that is, I have been telling you, habits don't get you, you let go of the habit.
Yeah.
You know, so something like this is striking, so people think. But we have to think. Stagnant, we don't go anywhere. And this is what I find in reality. People get stuck. They get into routine, doing things without thinking, without question. Okay, so priority is a dynamic phenomenon. You know, you don't follow the rules.
That to myself every
yeah, so you don't
every
follow
time
the
I'm ready to beat my head against the wall.
So there was a one master had a servant, you know, servant did everything. So master went and ordered, you know, the servants were there. And the master said, come on, get some cookies for the guest. So he grabbed a couple of cookies and brought in his hands. Listen, you don't bring things, you know. In the hands, you bring on the silver plate. So next time one other guest came, bring their shoes. You get silver plate, put the shoes in there, and brings the master. This is what you follow, the rules. You use common sense, that's the whole idea.
Put the shoes in the plate.
Yeah. So,
that's about right too. You ever work with anybody? Well, you were in construction, you wouldn't know. Go do this.
People are stuck. They don't think creatively. You know, they take one road, they take the same road. Even if there is detour, they don't change. So to break that habit is try challenging, you know, challenging road, new thing, new friends. It opens you up to be able to think. You know? So thinking, I think. thinking clearly is the answer. If you cannot think clearly, you don't see the problem, how can you solve the problem? You can blame on someone for your problem, or you can blame yourself for something else instead of real problem is somewhere else.
Oh yeah, I kind of have a similar reaction, like, oh my God, you're the jerk here, not me. And then in reality it comes back that,
yes.
No, I'm the problem, I have to.
That part is, if you think I am the problem,
yeah, that's an important part.
People take it wrong way, you know?
Yeah.
You are the problem, you blame yourself, you hate yourself, you're so bad. It's a compassion, love, forgiveness. So it's complex thing. So there is nothing could be taught in the world. It's dynamic, flowing, living. So this is why if you want to learn a spiritual lesson, observe a spiritual master doing ordinary thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, only so many spiritual masters want to teach their disciples real thing. Master sends somebody to the market, here is money, go get some vegetable. Here's a vegetable. How much did you pay? Paid so much? Should not be that much. So master is meticulous. So people say, well, spiritual master should not worry about money. Here the message is, you become meticulous with your thought, speech, action.
Mm-hmm.
You don't cheat others, but don't get cheated at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you forgive others, but you learn to forgive yourself also. So it's kind of thing.
That's really important that the affirmations come in too.
Yeah, those affirmations and constant awareness, thinking clearly,
mm-hmm.
being dynamic, resetting priority. Each day is like a new day.
Your jellyfish theory is good. I don't know if you ever heard of it. That don't be pushed. If you have 50 people demanding on you, and you can't be pushed by a jellyfish, like a jellyfish, and pushed around, okay, I'll do, yeah, just tell everybody, I mean, if I don't know what your business is, but in my business, when the people start lining up,
yeah.
I address them and tell them I'll be with them as soon as possible. I might make a joke. Look, I have two hands. That's what I have.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or if I'm trying to make a profit and they're trying to beat me up too bad, I'll say, I don't eat too much, but I got to eat. Okay? I mean, I'll try that. You know, I say, I got to make a profit.
Right.
You can beat me up all I want, but you know, I'll joke around with him, but I have to make money. It's business, you know what I mean? Or something
so
like this. So that's part of your
ego. Here is ego.
Right.
See, ego is not just being weak and people push you around. Ego that you become strong and you get your way. Then you evolve more into ego, you define it is to for good of others and for higher life.
Mm-hmm.
But we have to be strong. We cannot go back to animal life or cannot be homeless. That is not spiritual evolution. That is spiritual sleep. You know, darkness, sleep. I don't think that's not good. So you have to think that. And many times people judge, you know, others
that's
by external things.
That's
they